All right, a little flame rush rider that could made it to the finals. I would like to play first. Well, it's not a very keepable hand. Ooh, this is not a keepable hand either. This could be a quick match, or a quick game at least. You know, I think a four card hand is better than this hand. All right, well, is this better than, this is probably better than a three card hand, but not by a whole lot. All right, well, here we are. Let's see how things go. Ooh, mountain, doing it. If I draw mountain or mountain island, could have a legitimate shot here. Especially since Hordling Outburst deals with Wandering Champion quite well. Of course, there's a decent chance I never played a card this game, but all right, never mind. Played Seeker the way. This hand is looking quasi-real, considering it was a four-card hand with one land in it. Uh-oh. Oh, pressure point. Yeah, that's fine. Opponent's got to have a play now, right? Mantis Rider. Oh, all right. Never mind. This game is not remotely winnable. I guess if I draw Mountain, cast Hordling Outburst, attack for three lifelink, and have three 1/1s left to block, that is kind of nice. My opponent's not blocking, so I think I'd rather block the Wandering Champion. I'm gonna get 2-for-1 here, but that's okay. And I actually think it's worth trying to win this game, because I don't think it's completely unwinnable. Ooh, hopefully my opponent has the trick. That would be awesome. Alright, this is one of the ways I win this game. Is my opponent casting Sandblast, me having feet, my opponent having no responses, me gaining 4... Well, taking 3. But 2-for-1 my opponent, and then getting to cast Hordling Outburst, attack for 3. Still a stretch, but, you know, it's not... I'm not 0% to win, that is for sure. Alright. Oh, I get to attack for 4, even. That's even better. Hordling Outburst comes down. I get to play Swiftwater Cliffs, and... smash for 4 lifelink, putting my opponent to 17. Actually, it's going to be 17, although I guess the Mantis Rider to clock me as well. But if I draw, like, I don't know, Aerostorm and a land to kill Mantis Rider, really? Is this necessary? Alright, Sage of the Inward Eye. I guess my comeback was brief-lived here. Alright, I'm going to attack with Seeker of the Way, because I don't think my opponent's going to block with Sage of the Inward Eye. And I don't think I have, you know, anything to lose there. Still an Aerostorm away from potentially winning the game. If I Aerostorm the Sage, I mean, I guess my opponent's just going to have a spell here, isn't it? Well, if I Aerostorm the Sage, I still have a shot. But I have to draw almost exactly Aerostorm. And I have to draw it basically now. You know, Valorous Stance is the card I'm looking for here. Alright, attack with these. No point attacking with the goblins. It's actually better than drawing Aerostorm, because I get to cast a face-down Canyon Lurkers as well. No, I don't have a trick. Come on. I'm trying to mount a comeback here. I mulled a 4, my opponent had a Mantis Rider on turn 4. Okay, well, that's not good. Valor Stance counters Valor Stance. Show my opponent morphs and all that, because I don't care. If my opponent doesn't have a spell here and I have a barrage, it's for, yeah, that's lethal. My opponent is going to have a spell, and I'm going to lose. Burn away. Man, my Seeker of the Way did so much work, though. Again, this game was surprisingly close, considering... I'm mulliganed to 4. You know, it's still not done yet. If my opponent didn't have Sage plus multiple spells, I actually think I would win this game. Since I'm doing 10 damage, alright. Collateral damage, sacking. Ugh, the goblin moved around. It sacked the wrong goblin. hope that does not cost me the game. I should have an extra tapped goblin in play. My opponent should be at one less life. I still might be dead here, but... Yeah, you know, maybe I'm not. Maybe I draw Aerostorm and still win this game somehow. I mean, I had to just draw perfectly every single turn, but... Yeah, that's how it is. Barrage of Boulders. I am going to win this game. I think. My opponent has to have an actual good card here. Or they're just dead. They have no cards in hand, and they have to have a morph that does something. Oh, man, that was incredible. That was a game. That was a game for sure. One is a Free Weapon Master and War Behemoth. Oh, no big deal. Just, you know, the normal Mold of Horror versus Manus Rider. Eh, just pretty easily win. Well, my deck's great, so what can you say, right? Actually, the way it played out that game was pretty amazing, considering the opening hand. Well... Yeah, you know, I don't think there's anything I can improve on, especially given that performance. Probably going to lose two games where I keep great 7-card hands, but hey, you know, that was already worth it. That was just awesome.